Hello again, everybody. This is Brendan Dudley, Director of Evangelization at Our Lady of the Lakes. I hope you're doing well and having a fantastic week. I'd like to talk with you in this video about virtue and what it means to have a virtuous lifestyle. We know that the risen Lord Jesus calls us to a life of virtue and holiness as we follow him in all of our thoughts, words, and actions. So let's talk today about what is virtue. Virtue can be defined, as it is in the Catechism of the Catholic Church, as an habitual and firm disposition to do the good. Virtue is not firstly about our actions, but our interior way of being, how we are ordered on the inside. So again, a habitual and firm disposition to do the good. And we'll get specific throughout this video about what that looks like and what that means. Because as we know, to do the good can take a lot of different important directions. And the virtues, they govern our actions. They make sure that we're living the right way as God has designed us. The virtues also order our passions, making sure that we are channeling our energies in the right way, those passions God has given us. And so let's now talk a little bit more specifically about what the virtues are and how we're able to live them. Remembering that a virtue is often defined as the mean or the middle between extremes. And we'll get to that in just a minute. But you might say, what does it mean to live a virtuous lifestyle in general? If I do an action one or two times, does that mean I have that virtue within me? Not exactly. A virtuous lifestyle is about doing the good with consistency, with ease, and with joy. So we build up a life of virtue and habits of virtue by doing the good consistently in a way that's not burdensome, but with ease, and that brings us joy, allows us to delight in the goodness of God and delight in the goodness of how he has created us and called us to live. We can think about that similarly with muscle memory on an instrument. For example, I'm a drummer, and I would not say that I could play a certain song well because I happened to play it okay the first time on the drums. It would be after playing it consistently and with ease and with joy, not being tense or nervous, that I could say, oh, I'm playing that song well. I'm playing that song properly and with little to no mistakes. Similarly with our life of virtue. We're called to consistency, ease, and joy in how we are living. And there are four main virtues or ways of living, dispositions within us that point us towards the good that all of us can do, no matter who we are. These are called the cardinal virtues. Not cardinal like the bird, but cardinal as in the hinge virtues, like on a door. The door would fall apart without the hinge, right? It needs something to swing upon. Well, similarly, these virtues that we'll talk about, the four cardinal virtues, are the hinge for our life, making sure that we are channeling our lives in the right direction, living the way we should. Those four cardinal virtues are prudence, justice, temperance, and fortitude. Let's break those down for a minute. Prudence is about discerning the good and choosing the right means to achieve it in a specific situation. Justice is all about giving to God and to others what is due to them. And temperance is all about moderation in the use of goods, not having too little of something, not having too much of something, but having an appropriate moderation of what goods are available to us in the world. And what about fortitude? Fortitude is endurance, perseverance, strength in pursuing the good. Fortitude is about being able to get back up and try again and go forth in confidence and in strength in pursuit of the good, not letting ourselves be defined by our mistakes or our sins, but repenting, turning around, and trying again. And these four cardinal virtues, like so many other virtues, we acquire through education, through observation, through experience and through practice. And it takes a while to build up these virtues in our lives, but each of us can do this, most especially with God's help. Let's look briefly at a few other virtues, such as humility. Humility is the mean or the middle between arrogance, thinking that you know and can do everything, and self-loathing, where you don't think about yourself in a positive light ever, and you don't think you're able to actually do anything that's good or worthwhile. Humility's in between those two extremes that says, everything I have is a gift. I'm called to use my gifts and talents to serve others, and I can grow and learn from the skills and abilities of others and experiences of others that are different from mine. Let's also look at a virtue such as generosity. Generosity is that disposition, that way of being, that's in the middle between being stingy and not giving of yourself or of your goods to other people, and being what's often called profligate. Profligate is that other extreme, meaning that you're just wasting your goods and your money, and you're just spending everywhere and not even thinking about how to wisely use the material goods God has given you. So generosity is in the middle of that, saying, how can I best serve others with the material items I have? How can I best leave a beautiful impact on the world, sharing God's love by sharing the gifts I've been given? As we talked about earlier, virtuous actions must be consistently repeated for us to have a virtuous lifestyle, and that we acquire the virtues by education, by action, by perseverance. Every day is an opportunity to grow in all the virtues, and each one of us should seek to develop a virtuous character. A virtuous character, meaning a consistent way of being and seeing and thinking and speaking and acting that's aligned with how God has made us. And what about grace, God's divine life within us that we receive through Scripture and the sacraments and daily prayer? Well, grace empowers us to persevere in our pursuit of the virtues, to not give up, but to be empowered by God to live a consistent, holy life. We also should talk about how there are virtues that we can't get on our own. They absolutely come directly from God, and we're called to grow in them each day. These are called the theological virtues of faith, hope, and charity that allow us to believe in all that God has said and done for us and to trust Him with our hearts and minds completely. That's faith. The theological virtue of hope allows us to entrust our whole lives to God, knowing that He's going to support us and carry us through all the storms of our life and be there to guide us and uplift us in all of our blessings. Hope also is the virtue that allows us to long for the joys of heaven and to strive towards responding to grace that we might be in heaven one day with God and all of the saints and angels. We also have from God the theological virtue of charity, which allows us to love God for His own sake as our loving Father and Creator and as our Savior, and to love others as designed by God and as his sons and daughters. So faith, hope, and love, faith, hope, and charity are these three theological virtues that are infused within us at our baptism, strengthened in our confirmation, empowered through the Eucharist. And these virtues of faith, hope, and love, we are called to grow in every day, that we might shine the light of God through a life of virtue. A life of, for example, humility and generosity and fortitude, like we talked about earlier. Now, what about role models in virtue? Well, we can look to the saints, all the many thousands of saints officially recognized by the Catholic Church as being in heaven and as having lives worthy of imitation, worthy of being inspired by. The saints are a model of virtue. Now, outside of our Mother Mary, and of course, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, all the saints that we usually talk about, like St. Augustine or St. Teresa of Avila or Blessed Carlo Acutis, a recent saint who was made a blessed of the Catholic Church only last year, these saints were not perfect. Unlike, again, our Mother Mary, these saints were not perfect, but they were examples of virtue, examples of trusting their lives to God and focusing on how they could respond to His love each day. Now, of course, the ultimate saint is the Blessed Virgin Mary, our mother, sinless from the moment of her conception. And her humility, her docility, her ability to be led and taught by God is the example par excellence for us to grow every day in faith, hope, and love, and trust in God's plan as we continue to fall into the unknown and as we continue to see how God is guiding us. Mary is an amazing and ultimate example of doing that as a human being. So as we can see, the different saints are a model for a variety of virtues, and we encourage you to study the lives of the saints so that you can see how best their example can help you become a more virtuous person in our following of Jesus Christ as Catholics. And so, as we conclude this video, here are some fun take-home questions for you. Think this week about which virtues seem easiest to practice in your life. Which virtues seem most difficult for people in society today? And how would you say that self-discipline is the key to living any of the virtues? So we encourage you to think about those questions throughout this week. I will do that myself as well. Please know that we are praying for you. We ask you for your prayers as well, and we hope you're having a wonderful day. God bless you.